Yeah, being a race car driver is fun. And sure, tricking out million-dollar cars is fun, too. But what about us? Real people with real cars on real roads.
We need a show, too, and that's why I'm here.
It's my mission to put the fun back into real-life driving. Anything that has to do with driving is fair game, because my playground is the road most traveled.
It's a beautiful day.
So, I've got the drop top dropped, cruising down the highway, not a care in the world. Until...
Oh, hell no!
Busted.
Oh.
There's no worse sound in the world than hearing that siren and knowing the man is coming to get you.
Act normal. No fast movements. Everything should be okay.
How you doing, sir?
Hey, how you doing, officer?
Got your license, registration, insurance for me?
Embrace yourself, because you know what's coming next.
Yeah, I clocked you at 65 miles an hour in 55 zone.
65.
And the ticket is just the beginning of my problems. My insurance rates will skyrocket.
Sir, here's your license.
Thank you very much.
How do we protect ourselves from this happening to us?
Radar Roy, right?
Yes, sir.
Craig Jackson, you can call me CJ.
Man?
Radar Roy Rayer claims to know the secret that will keep you from ever getting a ticket again.
I'm a retired police officer. I was involved in law enforcement for 20 years. I was very heavily involved in traffic enforcement.
Okay.
Now Roy deals with both sides of the law. He trains police officers in the use of speed monitoring equipment and offers advice to regular drivers on how to keep from getting busted for speeding.
So then that means that you have a lot of good stuff.
A lot of good stuff.
Let's go check it out, Radar. Let's go.
The first thing you need to do is understand the technology you're up against. Police monitor traffic primarily using two different types of monitoring devices, laser and radar. Radar technology has been around much longer and is still more widely used by law enforcement.
Nationally, statistically, 80% are still using radar and 20% are using laser.
The limitations of radar are that it throws out a very wide beam. It does not work as well in heavy traffic.
At 500 feet, this radar beam is 67 feet wide.
When using radar, police must be trained in visual target identification. In other words, they have to be able to accurately guess the speed by sight. Then, using their radar, which will clock the fastest vehicle on the road, they confirm their sighting. Laser monitoring devices work well in any situation, but excel in heavy traffic. A laser gun sends out a beam no wider than 12 to 18 inches and can target specific vehicles.
It'll pick out any car in any lane, and it just gives you the exact speed reading and the range. So there's no doubt about which car you're getting.
So to keep that from happening to you, we're going to need some expert advice from Roy.
Come on, man.
All right, so what you got?
Well, the first thing you're going to need is a good radar detector.
Prices for quality radar detectors start out around $300 and go up from there. But the advantage of a good detector is that it will alert you to a police radar gun before they have a chance to clock your car.
Kind of nice about this new radar detector, with coupling with GPS, it does a couple of things.
This detector isn't constantly driving you crazy with false alerts. It automatically adjusts its sensitivity level depending on whether you're driving on the highway or in city traffic. But is the only reason to have a radar detector so you can intentionally break the law? Not according to Roy.
We don't encourage you to use this to become a poor or bad driver or speedy driver. That's not the intent of these devices. This is a device to make you more aware of what your surroundings are. 80% of accidents that are caused today are caused by drivers not paying attention.
Well, he sounds sincere. So, a quality radar detector alerts you to a radar gun. But what if the police are monitoring using laser?
Radar detectors do have the ability to detect laser, but if it does, it's too late. Okay. You've already gotten yourself a ticket. Laser is the speed of light. Okay. So what we use for laser is a laser jammer.
When police clock a car with laser, they typically target a bright object like the license plate. So laser jamming sensors are mounted in the grille of the vehicle.
Best way to explain it, a police officer shines a 50-watt light at you, mm-hmm. and you're going to shine back a 250-watt light back at them in the infrared okay. spectrum. You're going to flood out their light. They're not going to see you coming down the road. You're invisible.
It all sounds good in theory, but will it really keep me from getting a ticket? Let's put it to the test.
Now, without my radar detecting equipment, I'm kind of at the mercy of my own eyesight and my own awareness to know whether or not there's police officers around. So I kind of either have to keep it under the speed limit or drive fast and be super wary.
And as you saw earlier, that doesn't always work out so well.
How you doing, sir?
86 miles an hour. Now that is a ticket.
Now let's see what happens when equipped with the technology that Roy recommends.
Now I'm in Radar Roy's car right now, and I have laser jamming equipment and also radar detecting equipment. So let's see if this stuff really works.
When targeting other cars, you can see how easily their speed is clocked.
Here he comes.
But watch what happens when Roy tries to target the car that I'm driving, which is equipped with a laser jammer.
Now there they are right there. So right now he's hitting me with the laser gun, and my laser jammer is hitting him back.
I'm not getting any reading on him at all. He's invisible to me.
That noise is irritating. But if it works, I guess it's worth it.
Never got him. Completely jammed.
Okay. So a good radar detector combined with a laser jammer will give you the best line of defense. But remember, laws vary, and this technology is illegal in some states. Check locally before using any radar or laser protection in your vehicle. Coming up next on Test Drive.